Hey everyone, this time around I want to take a look back at a game that maybe many of you never heard of before or never played. It's the 1986 title Alex Kidd in Miracle World, and it was released on the Sega Master System at the time. Now when the game hit, Sega was really trying to push Alex Kidd as their main mascot, kind of like Sonic. So most of you at the time were probably stomping on Goombas and going down warp pipes. So I think it's worth taking a look back and just seeing how the other half lived. I just used air quotes, didn't I? Now, there's a story here somewhere about how you're a prince and your brother was kidnapped and you're trying to rescue him, yada yada yada. Let's get to the meat of the game. You'll find a great variety of levels here, ranging from underwater levels to grasslands, to forests, to mountains, and while those are pretty cliche locales in video games, it really feels like the developer worked hard to make each environment unique. Now, along with the levels, you'll encounter a great variety of enemies, ranging from the fairly common scorpion to what look like pterodactyls, with the randomly raging bull thrown in for good measure. But my favorites are the giant angry blue bear with the sword and the monkeys that throw stuff at you from the trees. Along the way, you'll be collecting money bags scattered throughout the levels. You can use the money you collect in the shops you come across on your journey. You can use them to buy power-ups, but mainly you want to use them to buy vehicles like helicopters, motorcycles, and jet skis. These all give you major advantages in whatever level you use them in. The motorcycle is sort of like the invincibility star in that you can run through just about anything, except spikes. Yeah, I'm no Evel Knievel. The helicopter and jet ski are used in more risk-reward type scenarios to collect, you guessed it, more money bags. You can make some big bank with the helicopter in particular. Just look at all that money. But if that propeller touches a block, you're in the water. The sound effects really work, from the ka-ching sound of collecting a money bag to the deep crunch you get from punching the blocks. The music, too, is very catchy. Just try to avoid humming this tune. Sometimes you'll come across question blocks, and these will either contain something good for you, like a ring that shoots powerful beams of power, or something bad for you, like a ghost that chases you all the way to the end of the level.
Just look at those moves!
I still got it. Boss battles are rock, paper, scissors affairs, but don't worry, there's a pretty easy pattern you can memorize. Like the first boss's head is shaped like a rock, so you use rock, then scissors, to get rid of him. Hey, the next guy is Scissorhead. What do you think you should start off with?
As you move along, occasionally a wise guy will explain more about who you are, your kidnapped brother, yada yada yada. Who cares? The guy gives you a helicopter.
A few things bother me to this day about the game. The jumping mechanic in particular can be very floaty and sensitive, which makes precision jumping, like what's found in this level, really difficult. Another thing that drives me nuts is the collision detection. Look at this, I'm getting the money bag, but it's not registering. Those things aside, Alex Kidd in Miracle World is a solid title and one of the most memorable platformers on the Sega Master System. You can still find the cart pretty cheap, but better yet, you can grab it for just $5 on the Wii Virtual Console. So whatever way you can get it, I say keep it.